the Samagri Shibir, Pushti Parivar UK, 19th of August 2018. This is the third Samagri Shibir that Pushti Parivar UK has today done. And I'm going to invite Bhavna Ben Lakhani, the chairman of Pushti Parivar UK. Along with her is Kokila Ben, who is going to teach us all the Samagris. So welcome, Auntie, and why did you think that this Samagri Shibir particularly was needed? Because this is the third time we are doing a successful one. So what made you think that this was needed?
Okay, first of all, JJ, Dhanvat Pranam, Bhagavat Smaran to all the Vaishnavs and all the viewers. We have been talking to a lot of youngsters. We've been seeing them in our katha doing the seva, volunteering, and we thought, why don't we get them involved more into the seva at home? Because a lot of parents do say that they come into Dhanva, they do darshan, but they do not put themselves into the seva. So we thought, why don't we just, all our trustees, we had a meeting and we just talk about it, that, you know, some of people have approaches, some do something for youth. There are so many things happening for youth, but practical things are not happening, the basic things. So we thought, I contacted about Kokila Ben, because she's a brilliant cook. She always provides us a lot of samagris during the katha for our sajavats and our darshans and stuff. So we just thought maybe she's the best person. She speaks English really well. We wanted to do it in English. I encouraged her to do something totally new. So she came up with a baking samagri, which I thought was an amazing idea. And it's a 15 minutes preparation. As you see the introduction video I have done before about the protocols, why we apply protocols of the bacteria, germs we carry around. You will see that also video we have done. And we have applied that here today, washed our hands, you know, all the things we shouldn't wear nail polish, you know, jewelry. All these things was discussed in the beginning of this Shibir before we can start this. So we thought that maybe do this baking and encourage them to do seva at home. So they might not be doing nothing at home, so they will probably just do one of this samagri and offer Thakurji. So that's a big start, somewhere they can start. And that's why we decided to do this Shibir.
Right. And obviously your inspiration has been JJ, you have been an inspiration to a lot of people.
Thank you.
As you know, even, I mean, all these Shibirs, obviously being the chairman of the Pushti Parivar UK, it has been quite an inspirational journey. Yeah. But obviously coming up with such ideas of how youngsters can join, obviously explaining the protocols of Pushti Marg. So you not only learn the samagri or the malaj or anything, but also the protocols and how you can maintain a basic decorum. What inspires you to do this?
I've been obviously following JJ for a long, long time. JJ Shree always says we should do something new. And something, he's always had this dream about learning about ourselves. We started Pushti Parivar UK years ago. It was not registered at that time. And we did knowing about ourselves, you know, who we are. So we thought, part of who we are, why do we need to do all this? Because all our senses, our mind, our body part, everything has been offered to Thakurji. And this is what the protocol Pushti Marag is all about. Mahaprabhuji started this the Seva Marag at home, just so we can introduce everything to the Thakurji. Our family, our house, everything. So we just thought, JJ has always inspired me. Thoughts goes in my mind and I'm listening to him. I said, oh, next thing I'm going to do this. So I always speak to JJ and say, yeah, why not? And he's one of the person, amazing personality, as we all know. He always says, do something. Do keep consistency. It's very important that we keep consistency. The youth has to learn to organize in a concentration, organization, learning about our marag in a different form, not just sajavat or being volunteering, but doing the samagri. And also tasting them to see why certain textures are there, why we offer Thakurji in a certain way, because, you know, we always say Bal Swarup Seva, so certain things are not allowed. So they need to know all that, apply that as a day-to-day life as well. So we want to be inspired more and more by JJ. So thank you, JJ, for all the support you've been giving us. And I think I had a lot of feedback to say thank you to all the Facebook viewers. We had messages from New Zealand, Canada, Australia, US. They've all been inspired by Pushti Parivar UK all around the world doing Shibir. And I would say, follow JJ's footstep. Wherever he sets Pushti Parivar, do take this opportunity to teach people And every state has got talented people around. Mm-hmm. Talented people like Cocky Ben, who I grabbed up. Talents, I look around, I see the talents, and I say, come on, you gotta do the Shibir for us. We have Vicky, we have other people who are very inspired, you know, they do the things by themselves. So Pushti Parivar is always looking for new talents, and we always say, if you know something, come and share, let's do it, you know. So yes, we do need to push them, give them confidence, but that's what it's all about. And JJ is giving confidence to me and the trustees and all around the world, all the Vaishnavs. Do something for yourself, do something for your Thakurji. So hopefully everybody appreciates this a bit, and next one will be announced soon.
Okay, now we'll be starting almond and chocolate biscuits because we need to cool the almond biscuits before we do the chocolate coating. And almond biscuits, we have 2 cups of almond flour, which I have used this cup. Milk powder, 1/2 cup, that is this one. 1/4 cup is ghee, that is this, and some elchi and some kesar strands. Okay, so now we will start. Would you like to come here with me?
Yes.
Okay, first we will be adding the almond flour in a bowl, and then basically you mix everything together. Okay, so that is almond powder, that is milk powder.
Just say that they would have washed their hands already.
You have washed your hands?
No.
Nice. Okay, then you add the icing sugar.
So they all measured first.
Yeah, they are measured. And so we will be adding 2 tablespoons of ghee.
So make sure everything is ready before you start.
Yeah, everything should be ready. Your oven should be on at 180 before you even start all this.
And all measurements should be ready before.
This is 2 tablespoons of ghee. This is kesar powder. We will just add a little bit of it. And some kesar strands. Just a pinch. And some bit of elchi. About 1/4 teaspoon. Now we will be mixing all this.
with the milk.
Would you want to mix it? We'll be adding the
milk,
about 2 to 3 tablespoons of milk. Add slowly so it doesn't become too soft. The dough should be like puri now. Puri banane na apne puri now. Press it nicely so it becomes nice and soft. So all the ingredients get mixed up nicely. It has to be like
proper.
Sometimes you know you need more milk as well. Press it like that, okay?
Okay.
See? All your fingers should go like that. So it becomes very soft. Only then you'll be able to make nice balls.
Okay.
Look. This is the way it should be. Want to try? That's the way it should be, okay? Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, now let's make some balls. I need 20 balls, so come here. I'll just do this and you make round nice round balls. Look, yeah. Here, don't freeze enough. I'll cut them for you, okay? So you make them very nice. If you don't want to use the chocolate coating, then we can use one of the cutters, the small one, yeah. And what you do, just put it here and press it little bit.
So
it gives you a nice design on the biscuit. Mm-hmm. But this one I will be showing you half chocolate and half almond. If you keep it too near, it will join together, yeah? And now, as I mentioned in the recipe, you just have to press it little bit like that.
Okay.
Little bit, not too much, okay?
Exaggerate.
Just press it little bit, very little, yeah.
Use your fingers.
That's it. You can even use a teaspoon, yeah? This will go in the oven for 15 minutes on the top shelf, okay? So these are the almond cookies with chocolate. I think it's 100 or 200 grams.
Yes, 100 grams.
With 1 teaspoon of ghee in it.
Yeah.
We put ghee in it because then it will give a good shine. Mix it well so we don't have any lumps in it. We put it in the microwave for 1 minute till it melts nicely. 1 teaspoon. Okay. Either you can do that, just the half the side, okay? Mm. Or you can do this, a sandwich. This is your best thing to do. What if you just keep half, yeah? You can do that as well. Or you can use a spoon. Okay. Or you can make a sandwich. It's okay, it's okay. We'll make some sandwiches.
You can do with white chocolate as well.
Yeah, we can use white chocolate.
Black chocolate.
Those who are very healthy can use
dark chocolate.
Mm, yes. Yeah. Okay. You are healthy. You can use dark chocolate.
Yeah.
And then Thakurji will have to do with dark chocolate.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, sure, definitely.
And then we'll let it dry in Bhavna Ben's fridge. Because it will take a whole day to dry it nicely.
Okay.
If you are in a hurry, then you can put it in the fridge.
Yeah.
Yeah? So.
Freezer, you mean?
No, not
no, fridge.
Fridge. Okay, so this is almond and chocolate biscuits, yeah?
Yes.
Okay, now we will be doing almond cookies, yeah? Those were biscuits, these are cookies. And we will be doing in this tray. So now we need 2 cups of almond powder, is that?
Let's show the cups here.
Mm-hmm. Half cup milk powder, it's this one. I'll show them. This one. 1/4 cup sugar. Icing sugar? Yeah, icing, or you can use icing and custard sugar, okay? Custard sugar. And then 2 tablespoons of ghee. Now we'll be adding the milk and we'll be using the kesar powder, okay? Saffron powder, about a pinch only. Okay, start mixing. Start mixing. Get your hands in.
Yeah.
Add milk little at a time so that it's not too soft. Yeah? We put these almond pieces at the bottom, chopped almonds. So when you take the almond cookies out, you'll see almonds at the bottom as well.
Oh, lovely.
If you add too much milk, what will happen? It will just blow up and the shape won't come out as nice as we want.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? So we'll take some ghee in your hand. This is enough, Rebecca. Okay, what we need, we just need a ball like that and then just put it like that. The odd size to it.
I think we could then start shaping them.
I think
that way it's easier.
I'll keep them. In case if there's too much milk or and the liquid is too much, just add some chopped nuts or milk powder in it, so it will become thick.
So is this texture correct?
It's yeah, this is a little loose, but yes, it's okay. We'll have nuts in it. So yeah. Okay, we need to sprinkle this almond flakes. We have some almond flakes here, and then again you sprinkle on the top. So if you see in your recipe, you will see a boat with almonds in it. Now we are doing chocolate macaroons, yeah? Another thing, ladies and gentlemen, I have written silicon sheet in the
silicon paper.
Yeah, paper.
Yes,
but this is from America, but we can get silicon paper.
Yes, here. We can
silicon
get
trays. Yeah. That's very good, so you don't have to be worried that, choti jaldi will be stuck.
It's just like a baking,
Baking sheet.
Baking sheet,
yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we'll start on chocolate coconut macarons here.
Sure.
Yeah. So 2 cups of desiccated coconut. Half a cup of milk powder. Quarter cup caster sugar or icing sugar. 2 tablespoons of ghee. Basically, I got this from America, but we can get them from Holland and Barrett.
The coconuts.
Coconut. So we will be rolling the balls in the coconut, and then we'll put them in these trays. I'm using these trays so you get little
pickup,
and that looks like a small tray. Okay, can we mix it now?
Okay. Yeah. Just to remind everybody, it's okay, it's been recording, that these samagris are not offered to Thakurji today. This is for learning purpose, but the protocols has to be applied. And I'm reminding everybody, no gold, no nail polish while we're cooking for Thakurji. This is very important. Yeah.
Again, not too soft, otherwise it will just bust up. Sometimes we need to add more milk because of the coconut. Some coconuts are very dry, so they need more coconut, more milk. Is it okay?
It's
better. Yeah. It should be a ball like that, okay? A hard one, not too soft. Yeah, so that is fine. So let's make some balls. Okay, press it in here.
Okay,
and then spread the coconut in here. You can use a flat tray like this as well, if you don't have a tray. But these trays I got from Morrison's, a pound each. Very convenient, very convenient to use.
So I'm expecting all of you to make one for Thakurji when you get home. One of these at least once a week. Okay? That's the whole purpose of organizing this Shibir. The youth has to offer one samagri or one of the recipes to Thakurji.
100%.
And I expect a text.
A photograph in the group. The Pushti Parivar UK group.
Not that everybody's doing something for Thakurji. Now we are doing tutti frutti biscuits. Okay, there are 2 cups chopped nuts here. They are these cups. And they have to be like this, okay? Not
coarse.
Coarse, not too chopped, not too thin. And 1/2 cup of milk powder. 1/4 cup of icing sugar. Basically all the recipes has the same ingredients. Texture, but mostly nuts and milk powder. Okay, we'll be adding tutti frutti because they are called tutti frutti biscuits. Red cherries and green cherries, okay? So it's about 1/4 cup.
Where do you get them?
Holland and Barrett,
everywhere. Got them as well.
And I got this from India, from Kenya. But they are called Angelica. You can get it from Tesco or any other Morrison shops. Okay, we'll add the ghee as well, 2 tablespoons. It's measured, so just add it. These measurements are better than using the cups at home. So then you get the exact measurements. Okay. Who is coming? Who is helping us?
Love.
Yes. Yeah, I don't want to.
Yeah.
We need round holes.
Okay.
Let's see how best you are. You are very good in decoration, sajavat. Let me see here. Because you'll be helping very soon.
Yes.
So love does offer samagri sometimes on his birthday, Thakurji.
Okay, now. Again, we'll be rolling them in the nuts because it's nuts biscuits, yeah, nuts cookies. So, okay, what you do? Sorry, do that, roll them like that, just put them here. Use this round and just better biscuits, so it's easy for you. Another thing is that you don't need to bake too much. It's only 15 minutes, each recipe needs 15 minutes. This samagri we can offer to Thakurji during Holi as well. Holi na divasoma because the colors chanda, tutti frutti.
Oh, lovely. Looks so young, nice.
Everything is roasted.
We'll make this nut cookies for 15 minutes. We are doing cashew fingers now.
Yeah.
After cashew fingers we are doing now. So it's 2 cups of cashew powder.
It's 2 cups.
Half cup milk powder. Quarter cup caster sugar. 2 tablespoons of ghee. 1 cup soft dough.
Okay, some people don't use the condensed, the vegans. So how can you replace certain of the, some of the, can you use soya milk or?
You mean? Then we have to do chasni, isn't it?
Yeah, then you do chasni, yeah. Then you don't use the...
What about milk powder? Any substitute to milk powder?
No. You mean ready-made milk, condensed milk?
But yeah. You can make some at home. Vegan.
Oh,
for
vegan.
Vegan.
Oh, okay.
Then you can't use this. There's no... You have to...
You can't use dairy product?
Nothing at all.
Nothing.
Our Thakurji is vegan.
So you have to do chasni, yeah. You have to do chasni.
Chasni is the best.
For milk powder, we can just use almond powder or something.
Yeah. But you can use almond milk as well. We get almond milk.
Yeah.
So what you do, take a bowl of milk powder, put about quarter...
No milk powder.
No milk powder.
Oh, no.
No milk powder either. That's why.
Vegan is
but you can use almond, isn't it?
Almond milk.
Yeah, so you can use almond
instead of the proper milk.
Proper milk.
Powder, instead of milk powder.
Yeah, so you can't use any milk product, right? Mm-hmm. So in your almond powder, you mix, take a bowl of almond milk and about half a bowl of sugar. Mm. Let it boil till it bubbles and that's the substitute you can use.
Okay, that's fine. Hmm? I'll try it again.
Oh, it's ready?
Yes.
Ask the question. Okay, what we have to do, can you just rub it nicely? So we are using a back side of the tray, yeah, to make cashew fingers. We put some butter, ghee on top. And now all you have to do is make a square. Okay. Here, take some. In your hands. Not too thin, yeah?
Okay.
Yeah, that's it. And then what you do, you make it into a square. I'm still not ready. Or you can use the rolling pin.
Yeah.
But for youngsters, I think it's better they learn this way first. Rolling, what will happen with rolling pin, it will become more thinner. Mm. But by doing with hands, you can control the size and the thickness. So we'll bake this for 15 minutes. And When it's ready, we will cut it immediately after 5 minutes. Yeah, otherwise you won't be able to cut it nicely. And you can do the similar with almond flour.
You have to bake it.
Yeah. Same what we did with cashew flour, you can do it with almond flour.
And same with pista as well.
Yeah.
Three layers.
Yeah, you can do it.
Three layers,
So they are nearly ready, so just cut them like this, They're still very hot. But if you leave it too long to cool down, you won't be able to cut it. So when you take it out from oven, leave it for 5 or 10 minutes and then cut into pieces. You leave this to cool, then you take it out. So we have 2 cups of mixed nuts. We are using this cup again. 1/2 cup of
milk.
Two cups. Right? Condensed milk is coming. And it's not in the recipe about the milk powder, but we can add some milk powder. Okay. So we will be adding some milk powder here. That is about 1/4 bowl. So whenever you have your recipes, plus you can add it, it's an option. It doesn't have to be milk powder, but you can add it here. And then 2 tablespoons of ghee. This will be doing in the that mold.
My favorite. Your favorite.
And 2 tablespoons of milk. Milk to thodu kaj we add, then we are adding condensed milk.
Shift.
What about the biscuits?
Height to join. Make looking.
No, I don't need it now. It has to cool down.
Okay. That's fine.
Any questions still? Yeah, wait. We have almond nuts, pista nuts, cashew nuts, and peanuts. But peanuts are only on the nut cookies.
It's very hot.
This is a basic burfi as well. Chocolate is just addition we are putting on it. But this is the way to do it. You can put in all these molds, whichever molds you like.
Can use any designs you want.
Yeah. Little bit loose, so we add some nuts in. Even you can come. You wanted to do this, Once it cools, the condensed milk cools down, it will become hard. So then we just put them in here. Still loose, wait.
Didn't bother.
As I mentioned before, if it becomes too loose, just add couple of milk powder, couple of teaspoons. So 1, 2, 3, 4. It has to be a bit firm. If you are using the mold, leave the tip bit open. It should be little bit because it's quite warm. We'll put this in the fridge so we can do the chocolate. But at home, you can do it in the morning, leave it, and in the evening, you can put the chocolate, or you can put the nuts, you can put tutti frutti, whatever you want to do. You can use some ghee in your hands.
All the pretty things takes time.
We'll put this in the fridge for a little while, yeah? So when you take it out, there are some nuts.
So it's better to put it underneath. I think it seals very well. Because when you put it on the top, it falls off, doesn't it?
Yeah. Press it, exact mold. Because it's condensed milk. You need ghee?
Yeah. Okay.
એટલું બાકી છે.
I would encourage all around the world to do CVs like this so people can be
influenced. No,
it's done. Look, this is the which should be. And what we will do?
Wow, chocolate.
It's Bantaji.
Yeah. You can use for Bantaji, you can use for Shingas, Shinga Samagri.
Can you do that, sure?
Also, I'd like to say thank you to all the Facebook followers, likes we've been getting. They've been sending us messages saying they want recipes and they want to see this live. We could do the live. So what we're going to do now is we're going to put this on the YouTube and people can benefit by watching it at home. So thank you to all the Instagram followers, all the Twitters, all the Facebook. We've got a great support from you all. Thank you.
We are making coconut balls now, okay? So basically what we do is mix everything and condensed milk is coming, okay? Okay, we are doing coconut balls. So basically it's just one cup of desiccated coconut.
Let's speak it louder, yeah? So yeah, I can record it.
Half cup of milk powder. 2 tablespoons of ghee, 5 teaspoons of condensed milk, warm condensed milk. Condensed milk and milk depends on the coconut and the quantity and the nuts as well. Sometimes you need more. So what's in the recipe, you might need a little bit more. We'll be putting tutti frutti on the top, just for decoration. Yeah. I'll hold you. Okay, tight. Okay, now we can make small balls. You can decorate them in this sort of
cake cups.
Cake cups, yeah. All you do is put some dried cherries on it. It can even be done with
nuts.
Mixed nuts. Mm.
If they're offered fresh, you can use fresh fruits.
Yeah.
On top?
Yeah, on the top. Yeah. This place they get fresh cherries.
Yeah. Mm. There's something like strawberries, cherries according to the season.
You can do it. Just have to play around with nuts and milk powder and sugar. Mm-hmm.
But this has given a lot of confidence to a lot of people.
Yeah, absolutely.
To even play around.
Play around means tomorrow you feel, let me give something different to offer something different to Thakurji. You might think of apricot. Okay, let me mix some apricots in the milk powder with nuts and roll them up. Thakurji might like it.
Yes, as a bantaji you can put it.
Yeah.
Figs go well.
So by watching videos is good that you do get techniques and stuff. But coming here physically, this is why I'm encouraging a lot of Vaishnavas to come physically, get involved, is to feel confident afterwards that you can actually make it yourself.
I thought, can you make more decorative? You want me to do it?
Yeah, you can do it.
This is 1.5 cup of dates.
Spoon left.
A youngster to help me. So basically 1 cup of chopped almonds, 1 cup of chopped pistachios, 1 cup chopped cashew nuts, coconut for decoration, and some peanuts, half a bowl of peanuts. Yeah? So we'll be mixing all that. If this happens, you can put this in the microwave for 2 seconds.
Okay.
And it will become loose, that we can use this. So we'll be adding to the dates the chopped pistachio, cashew nuts, we'll leave that for decoration, and almonds. And 2 tablespoons of ghee. Okay, in the recipe we have written condensed milk as well, but let's see how. If it's too hard, then we'll be adding the condensed milk. Need another tray. Is it too hard?
No.
Want to do it in here?
No, no, no.
I'll be adding 2 teaspoons of condensed milk. Yeah?
This is not baking, it's just...
No baking at all. This is optional. I have written in the recipe, if you need it too sweet, then you add this. These are very healthy as well. Because we are offering to Thakurji, we are adding the ghee.
Yes.
Yeah? Otherwise, if it is... If you want to eat it on its own, you don't need to add sugar, you don't need to add ghee or anything, just mix it well.
You can eat, you can add pumpkin seeds,
yeah.
You can add any of the healthy options.
Yeah, you can. And every morning you can have one.
Yeah, it's an energy boost. Huh?
Chia seeds and
that's it.
You know, magaj, you know, seeds.
Yeah,
seeds. All the seeds you can use. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's fine. Mm-hmm. You need young people. Okay, all we need is to make laddus and then you just roll them in the coconut like that. You can come and help. Come.
Dwani.
Chavo.
Some you can do it in the coconut. Yeah, this is the roasted coconut, by the way. Desiccated coconut.
So we have a video and the youngsters doing it, so no excuse for them to say they don't know how to do it.
It's anyone.
Okay,
let me do this. Yeah. And on one side we have coconut here. Oh, another option, if you want to do, do that and roll it up. So everything sticks on it. Yeah? Yeah? So this is better.
One cut, other three cut. Go to the other side if you can't reach. I'll pay the edge. So how do you guys feel doing this first on the live?
Confident and
pleasure to offer. Can't wait to offer
Thakurji. I think doing it personally allows you to,
physically and personally, it does make a lot of difference.
Yes.
Because it gives you that, you can feel the texture and you can feel how the consistency should be. Thank you.
add the nuts, lettuce, take the coconut and all mixed nuts.
So just to recap, how did you prepare the dates?
So how did you find the shibir? How was it?
It was amazing. It's really great to learn this thing, and it's good to offer to the Thakurji. Thakurji will be so happy, and I can't wait to learn more samagri, even including ansakhri. The heads of the Ppuk UK is arranging all the things with the place of the Yadunathji Mahodayshree.
So what did you find new in this shibir?
Basically, this normally we do see these all the videos in YouTube, but now actually Ppuk give us the opportunity to make ourselves, to physically do how we can do ourselves, and then and we offer the Thakurji.
Right, so our youngest today member of Samagri Shibir, what did you learn?
Normally in videos, you see in videos, like you don't know how the texture is, but in like real life, you actually can see it and you can feel the texture, so it helps more.
So you're going to make one now. Which one was the favorite of yours from all of these? This one,
right?
It looks pretty. Okay, so you like the presentation of it. So out of all the samagris, did you learn that how you would like to do the presentations differently? Great, so we'll see a photo from your end. Good. Right, so Krishna, when you have prepared the pamphlet, obviously, you know, the excitement was growing.
I just did copy pasting.
How did you find when it came in real?
Yeah, it's an amazing experience, and thanks to Pamela Ben and Kokila Ben for arranging this and teaching it us. Because sometimes when we see a recipe online, we don't know, we don't have the confidence how to do it ourselves. But over attending the shibir, we learn how to do it. So it gives us more confidence.
What new things would you like to have in Ppuk shibir-wise?
Shibir-wise, as Pamela said earlier, if we learn about how to decorate Hindora, that will be a really good one.
Yeah. Right. Okay. So already looking forward for another shibir.
Yes.
So heads up to Bhavna Aunty and all the other Ppuk members. Great, thank you. તો કેવું લાગ્યું કિરણ પણ પહેલી શિબિર હતી તમારી આ
ના મેં આની પહેલા પણ શિબિર અટેન્ડ કરી છે અદ્ભુત છે થેન્ક યુ કોકિલા બેનને અને ભાવના બેનને પીપીયુ કેને થેન્ક યુ સો મચ કે આટલું સરસ સુંદર શીખવા મળ્યું ઘણું બધું આ ઉંમર ફર્સ્ટ ટાઈમ મેં આ બેકિંગની આટલી બધી આઈટમ શીખવા મળ્યું અદ્ભુત છે
અચ્છા અને આ તમે સામગ્રી શિબિર આની પહેલાની અટેન્ડ કરેલી છે
હા કરી છે ને શિંગારની
તો આ વખતે શું નવું તમને લાગ્યું શું શીખવા મળ્યું નવું શું શીખીને જાવ
બેકિંગનું જે ઠાકોરજીને કોઈ દિવસ કહેલું નથી જે અદ્ભુત છે ઠાકોરજીને મને એક્સાઇટમેન્ટ છે કે હું જલ્દી ઘરે જઈને આ બધું ઠાકોરજીને બનાવીને નવી નવી વસ્તુ બનાવીને ઠાકોરજીને
ઓકે
અદ્ભુત છે
થેન્ક યુ Kokilandi, this is your second time in Pushti Parivar UK.
Third time
that you have been teaching Samagri.
Yes.
And everyone has been enjoying so far. As Dhananji already mentioned, this is a third successful Samagri Shibir. So thank you so much. How do you feel?
Oh, I feel so good that so many Vaishnavas are here and all the youngsters are here. And we would like to have more youngsters to come and learn so they can offer Thakurji the new samagris of the time.
I'm sure you know this is because this is the third time so you know samagri wise you're confident on the versions but what makes you feel think about new samagris how do you plan this when you come here and teach and give so many recipes to us
well basically what I do I just put all the nuts in front of me the sugar the ghee the milk and everything and then I also cut lots of dried fruits like apricots figs dates and all the dry fruits that we get in the market so then I just decide shall I mix this and see how it becomes so what I will do the burfi mix like milk powder and mixed nuts and ghee and sugar and then you mix some mix for dry fruits in it roll it up or press it in one of the molds I have shown and they come out beautiful
Right. So that is your
inspired.
The more you do, the more you get exciting and stuff.
Exciting.
Right. So I mean, obviously, you are a member of Pushti Parivar UK. Jejeshree has been inspiring all of us.
Yeah.
How has been he inspirational to you in providing this seva to Pushti Parivar UK?
Jejeshree smile. If I look at him and if I see his smile and I feel, oh, I must do something extraordinary for him and for Pushti Parivar.
Yes.
And
also,
being on my back and she has inspired, Okila Ben Kara, you can do it. I wasn't confident at all, but with Bhavna Ben's inspiration, she kept on telling me, Nana, kari sabso, kem ni kari sako, karo. So that's how I have
learned. Shibir soon and hopefully you come up with a lot of such great samagris for all of us.
Definitely.
Thank you so much.
For all my Pushti Parivar and all my Vaishnavas, I will definitely try to.
Yes, I'm sure we'll have a lot of new faces as well.
Next year.
Oh, you're launching a book next year.
With Jayajayasri's Archival.
Wow.
I have asked him if I can write a book on so many Vaishnavas around the world will benefit from that.
Great. So to the viewers, so this new book is coming out, which
next
is going to be launched in next Katha with Jayajayasri's Ashirvad. So I'm sure we all are on the lookout for that book now, as much as we are on the lookout for the Katha. So there are two attractions now, the Katha and the book. So thank you so much and hope Ke Thakurji ne aap aavi sundar samagri dhara taro, amne badane sikhvarta ro. And I hope to, you know, all of you obviously are smiling, conveying to taste the samagris that we have made, and let Thakurji ne bada tamara thaki you all learn, and then amra Thakurji ne dharavsu. So thank you so much. Right, so તમે ઇન્ડિયા થી અહીંયા આવ્યા છો અને યુ નો સામગ્રી શિબિર માં તમે ઇન્વોલ્વ થયા છો આની પહેલા આઈ થિંક તમે માલાજી શિબિર માં પણ હતા, તો કેવું લાગે છે?
ખૂબ જ આનંદ થાય છે અને ખરેખર અદ્ભુત અનુભવ થાય છે કે જે ઇન્ડિયામાં અમે નથી કરી શકતા એ અહીંયા લંડનમાં આટલી બધી પ્રચાર છે અને વૈષ્ણવોને નવું નવું બધું જાણવા મળે છે કે જેનાથી આપણો જે પુષ્ટિ માર્ગ છે એનાથી આપણે અલિપ્ત ન થઈ જઈએ, એના માટે આપણે વૈષ્ણવોને કેવી રીતે જોડી રાખવા પુષ્ટિ માર્ગમાં કે જેનાથી યંગસ્ટર્સને આ બધું શીખવા મળે, તો પુષ્ટિ માર્ગ શું છે અને પુષ્ટિ માર્ગમાં આપણે શું કરી શકીએ છીએ એ બધું જાણવા મળે છે. ખરેખર આ એક અનુભવ એટલો સારો છે કે જેનું વર્ણન જ નથી કરી શકાતું. ખરેખર બહુ મજા આવી મને આ જાણીને, ખૂબ સરસ છે.